This gorgeous, gorgeous girl is Lombard. I was contacted by one of my favorite shelters down in Salem, Indiana. Terrific folks there, wonderful to work with. And she had this one and Gable at the same time. That's kind of the matching names. That's not her real name. She can learn a new one. We just need kind of a unique identifier when they come in. She said she's probably 3 years old. Very nice. Housebroken. She said she does kill chickens. I'm not sure about little kids, but I pulled on her tail, flipped her on her back, squeezed her feet, blew in her nose, hugged her, and got no negative reaction from her. She said we'll get her heartworm tested. No dog issues that we saw. The house she came from had an 8-month-old pup. They did say food aggressive, but that's easy to fix. We fed treats and didn't see any issues. She emphasized again that she is housebroken. She said, I love this dog. She's very calm. When we had her in the office, she chose to stay by me rather than interact with the dogs. When we actually set up a dog check, she was fine, but she's more a people dog than a dog dog. She does no sit, and we'll check that out in a minute here. They said she was purchased off Craigslist 3 months ago, and she had a temporary name, but you know, we'll just give her a rescue ID here, and you can call her whatever you want when you take her home. She was in the cat room, did not seem overly interested in cats, and remind me what we just, oh, look at the cross paws. Oh, so you undid it? That was a good thing. Remind me what we just saw with the cats. After this minute, they start to run together. How did she react to the cats?
She kind of ignored it.
Okay.
She was pretty blasé.
Okay. Then the volunteers last week said she was a little shy till she saw I just wanted to pet her. Then she started lobbying to go home with me and trying to slip in some kisses. She's a gentle girl, seems mature and well-behaved. She is really, I mean, this is how she's acted the whole time, just super calm. She is heartworm positive, so we'll have to have her treated for heartworm. And then she has a small mammary tumor that is, I guess it's very localized, gonna be real easy to get out of there. So we'll get her through heartworm treatment, and she is going to foster, and then get that surgery done, and she'll be ready to go home. And one of our foster dads has a lovely older female husky. I think she's maybe 10, 11, 12, something like that, but she definitely qualifies as senior. And just a real sweet cupcake of a dog. So he wants somebody he can bring home that won't be, you know, threatening to her. And I guess he brought Aurora up here, and she met Lombard, and he was just in love. I mean, he liked her right off and decided to foster her. So she's one of the lucky ones. She has a few medical challenges ahead, including the heartworm treatment. But she'll get to go to a home environment to recover, and sounds like she's a good candidate for that. And boy, if it were me, I would be getting my application in, so I'd be approved and ready to take her home when she's ready to go home. Because this one, well, this is my kind of dog. I like this kind of husky right here. One that's got about my energy level, huh? And she does like being petted. I don't know if we did the squeaky or not. Did we squeak for you? What's that? So, okay, whatever. I'm a good girl. Let me zoom in on that gorgeous face. You have pretty faces. Don't be scared. Use a camera. This is Lombard. Pretty girl. Oh, a nice smile for the camera. And she does do the cross paws, which for me is always a selling point. Okay. I'm doing video. If you want to show her cats. She's very pretty. What do you think about that kitty?
Cat food over there. I see the cat food.
She certainly wasn't interested in the cats, was she? Hi. Hi. Hi, sweetheart. Aren't you nice stopping by to say hello?